In this video, we will know about the apparatus used in chemistry lab. These are some photographs of our laboratory. Test tube rack. Test tube rack is a laboratory equipment that is used to hold upright multiple test tubes at the same time. Test tubes. A test tube is also known as a culture tube or sample tube. It is a common piece of laboratory glassware consisting of a finger-like length of glass or clear plastic tubing open at the top and closed at the bottom. Test tube holder. It is used to hold test tubes. It is used for holding a test tube in place when the tube is hot or should not be touched. Test tube brush. It is a spout brush. It is a brush used for cleaning test tubes and narrow mouth laboratory glassware such as beakers and flasks. A spatula is a broad, flat, flexible blade used to mix, spread, and lift materials. Policeman. A policeman is a handheld flexible, natural, rubber, or plastic scraper. The common type of it is attached to a glass rod and used in chemical laboratories to transfer residues of precipitate or solid on glass surfaces when performing gravimetric analysis. Watch glass. A watch glass is a circular, concave piece of glass used in chemistry as a surface to evaporate a liquid to hold solids while being weighed for heating a small amount of substance and as a cover for a beaker. Beakers. A beaker is a generally cylindrical container with a flat bottom. Most also have a small spout or beak to aid pouring as shown in the picture. Wash bottle. A wash bottle is a squeeze bottle with a nozzle used to rinse various pieces of laboratory glassware such as test tubes and round bottom flasks. Funnel. There are many different kinds of funnel that have been adapted for specialized application in the laboratory. Filter funnels, thistle funnels, and dropping funnels have stopcocks which allow the fluids to be added to a flask slowly for solids. A powder funnel with a wide and short stem is more appropriate as it does not clog easily. Filter paper. Filter paper is a semi-permeable paper barrier placed perpendicular to a liquid or air flow. It is used to separate fine substances from liquid or air. Filter paper has various properties. The important parameters are wet strength, porosity, particle retention, volumetric flow rate, compatibility, efficiency, and capacity. Is how we use a filter paper. And in the second picture is a scan of Wattmann filter paper which we use in our laboratories. Fluorescence flask. A fluorescence flask is a type of flask used as an item of laboratory glassware. It is used as a container to hold liquids. It has a round body, a single long neck, and often a flat bottom. It is also known as flat bottom flasks. Volumetric flask. A volumetric flask, that is also called measuring flask or graduated flask, is a piece of laboratory glassware, a type of laboratory flask calibrated to contain a precise volume at a particular temperature. These are used for precise dilutions and preparation of standard solutions. These flasks are usually pear-shaped with a flat bottom and made of glass or plastic. Conical flask or round bottom flask or Erlenmeyer flask. An Erlenmeyer flask, also known as a conical flask or titration flask. It is a type of laboratory flask which features a flat bottom, a conical body, and a cylindrical neck. It is named after the German chemist Emil Erlenmeyer, who created it in 1860. Graduated cylinder. A graduated cylinder, measuring cylinder, or mixing cylinder is a common piece of laboratory equipment used to measure the volume of a liquid. It has a narrow cylindrical shape. Each marked line on the graduated cylinder represents the amount of liquid that has been measured. Bunsen burner. A Bunsen burner, named after Robert Bunsen, is a common piece of laboratory equipment that produces a single open gas flame which is used for heating, sterilization, and combustion. The gas can be natural gas, which is mainly methane, or a liquefied petroleum gas, such as propane, butane, or a mixture of both. Bunsen burner flames depend on airflow in the throat holes on the burner side, not the needle valve, for gas flow. First, air hole closed. First flame is when air hole closed. Second flame is air hole slightly open. Third flame is air hole half opened. And fourth flame is air hole fully open. We can see in the picture first, second, third, and fourth respectively. Wire gauge. A wire gauge is a sheet of thin metal that has net-like patterns or a wire mesh. Wire gauge is placed on the support ring that is attached to the retort stand when the Bunsen burner and the beakers, in order to support the beakers or other glassware or flask during heating. This is Bunsen burner stand, or also known as tripod stand, used to hold laboratory glassware while heating. This is how to use Bunsen burner while heating a glassware. Thermometer. A thermometer is a device that measures temperature or a temperature gradient. A thermometer has two important elements. First, a temperature sensor, that is the bulb of a mercury in glass thermometer, or the digital sensor in an infrared thermometer, in which some change occurs with a change in temperature. And second, some means of converting this change into a numerical value. For example, the visible scale that is marked on a mercury in glass thermometer. Evaporating dish or porcelain dish. An evaporating dish or watch glass is a piece of laboratory glassware used for the evaporation of solutions and supernatant liquids and sometimes to their melting point. Most are made of porcelain or borosilicate glass. Crucible. A crucible is a small vessel made from ceramic. It is used to heat various type of chemicals that are required a very high temperature, usually solid chemicals. Crucible tongs. Crucible tongs are scissor-like tools, but instead of having two blades, these tools are replaced with two pincers or pieces of metals that concave together, which allow the users to grasp a hot crucible, flask, evaporating dishes, or even small beakers. Clay triangle. A pipe clay triangle is a piece of laboratory apparatus that is used to support a crucible being heated by a Bunsen burner or other heat source. Pipette. A pipette, sometimes spelled pipette, is a laboratory tool commonly used in chemistry, biology, and medicine to transport a measured volume of liquid. Burette. A burette is a laboratory equipment used in analytical chemistry for the dispensing of variable amount of a chemical solution and measuring that amount at the same time. It is a long, graduated glass tube with a stopcock at its lower end and a tapered capillary tube at the stopcock's outlet. Burette clamp and stand. Burette clamp is a scientific equipment which used specifically to hold and secure a burette on a stand so that a burette is fixed and more convenient for the experiment. Utility clamp. It is a laboratory apparatus resembling a pair of scissors. The screw in the middle works as the wide adjustment of two prong. It composes of three parts: two prong adjust, metal rod, and clamp down. This apparatus is connected to ring stand or retard stand and used to hold rounded laboratory glassware, for example, a beaker, flask, etc. Forceps. Forceps are a handheld hinged instrument used for grasping and holding objects. Forceps are used when fingers are too large to grasp small objects. Chemical balance. Weighing scales or chemical balances are devices to measure weight. This is how our chemical balance looks like. These are the parts of our chemical balance. Weight box and fractional weight set. Weight box contains 9 brass weights, one each of 1 gram, 5 gram, 10 grams, 50 gram and 100 gram size, and two each of 2 gram and 20 gram sizes. In polished wooden box with a 1 to 500 milligrams fractional weight set, 5 milligram rider and forceps. This is our weight box and fractional weights. Glass rod or stirring rod. A glass rod is a piece of laboratory equipment used to mix chemicals and liquids for laboratory purposes. They are usually made of solid glass, about the thickness and slightly longer than a drinking straw, with rounded ends. Passing tubes are glass tubes. Glass tubes are mainly cylindrical hollow wares used to pass the liquid or gas. Capillary tube. These tubes are used in the determination of melting point of solids and boiling points of liquids. Here we can show how to fill our inorganic or organic solids in the capillary. This is how to use a capillary in the determination of boiling or melting point. Thanks for watching.